The frame of this fork-loaded bulk bag unloader is fabricated of 1/4 inch thick, 3- and 4-inch square tube steel. It features a removable bag lifting adapter that rests on receiver arms that can be adjusted in 1-inch increments. A bag support pan provides the safe access that OSHA and safety managers are looking for, and is also used to motivate the bag shaker system. This is an effective, flow-promoting system for materials that will not free flow from the bag. Using 4 rubber isolators and a heavy-duty gyrator, the pan and the bag are shaken, refluidizing the material to ensure complete discharge from the bag. The 100% duty cycle vibrator has 1,500 pounds of max force and is the machine's only moving part. It is completely adjustable and will likely never be replaced. To unload a bag, the lift loops are fed onto the lifting adapter and the bag can now be placed onto the receiver arms. The forklift then backs out of the adapter. The receiver arm should be placed so that 80 to 90% of the bag weight is sitting on the pan. The operator can then open the access door to reach the bag spout. If the unit has an iris valve, it can now be opened via either a trigger lock or a twist handle lock like the one shown here. The operator then pulls down the bag spout, closes the iris valve, and can untie the spout. Once the access door is closed, the valve may be opened again and the dust-free system is ready to discharge. The iris valve can also be used to close off and retie the bag when removing it from the system. However, materials must be flowing through the spout to close. Forcing it closed on a solid mass can cause it to slip out of orientation. The bag shaker is actuated by either a simple on-off switch, like the one shown here, or automatically by downstream conveyors or control systems. Once the bag has been discharged, tying off the spout is typically recommended. Then the empty bag can be removed via the bag lifting adapter. Please contact your FormPak representative for more information on this or other FormPak products.